some of the most difficult and challenging patients are really those patients in their mid to late 40s as their skin starts to change and they have dryness and irritation. They don't necessarily know what to attribute this to, but they come to us for answers in terms of products and procedures that they can use. And in reality, it's a much more complicated process than just age-related changes. Estrogen has been found to have many different roles in the skin, from moisturizing to rigidity to wound healing to moisture retention and other things that are really important throughout the layers of the skin. As people get older, it's not something that's just immediate. There's just a gradual change in the appearance of people's skin and the ability for estrogen to really target the skin. And with diminishing estrogen levels, those are manifested in cutaneous changes that we're all too familiar with. And an efficacy study looking at 80 patients, twice daily application for 14 weeks, of course, they were not allowed to use the various things that may alter the skin that we're used to seeing in terms of clinical trials. And the study endpoints were skin thickness, fine lines, et cetera. And you can see where I highlighted in red the improvement in dryness, dullness, thickness of the skin, laxity, as well as erythema complete compared to placebo. And then if we look at the subset analysis, this is the amount of estrogen receptors on fibroblast. This actually showed that there is, within the presence of MEP, there is an upregulation of these estrogen receptors on these fibroblasts. So the conclusion was that this may be a very effective way for people to actually topically help with estrogen deficiency, but not have any systemic absorption. BioPel has a serum, which is a day serum, and they have a night cream, which actually has a retinoid in it as well. I did an experience trial on this and specifically looked at real life experience where people applied this, the serum during the day and the cream at night. And this is an example patient at 8 weeks. You can see some of these parameter improvements in terms of redness and dullness. And when one of the parameters was patients literally rubbing their hands over these areas and it felt smoother. This is also at 8 weeks. And then I just want to point out that this is a patient at 20 weeks, and this was similar for other patients that were older as well. And with that point that I made about the upregulation of the estrogen receptors with continued application, this was one of those patients that really showed that, where somebody may not appear to be a responder at 8 weeks or at 12 weeks, but by 20 weeks, they certainly appear to be a pretty significant responder. And as the mean life expectancy in this country and other countries has increased significantly, the number of people living longer and having these symptoms of estrogen deficiency are growing. And many people aren't really aware that this is an option. So if somebody's been in menopause longer, they may take longer to respond, but they may still have a very nice improvement.